Hi, I'm Todd Watkins. That's me in the slide, playing Pied Piper. I took a group of students this summer from Lehigh University. I'm an associate professor of economics at Lehigh in the College of Business and Economics. And we took a group of students to Honduras this summer to more or less put a human face on the problems of microfinance and to work with a microfinance institution in Honduras to develop a technology to help them reduce some of the costs of doing business in microfinance. The program allowed us to combine some engineering students with some business and economics students to develop a technology for this MFI, the microfinance institution. This is a rural village that we visited in the middle of Honduras. It's right near La Entrada. We took students there to visit with some recipients of the microfinance loans that these institutions are giving. These loans are typically between $50 and $100, maybe $200. And we visited this town in order to see the process of microfinance at work. Honduras has significant problems with rural poverty. It's the second poorest country in Central America, and we were trying to work with a network of about 25 microfinance institutions that serve about 160,000 clients in Honduras. This sign was welcoming us to the group in this small town in La Entrada. Groups are formed in order to receive the loans. Very often these loans are given to groups in order to increase the probability that the loans are paid back. But the other thing that the sign is indicative of is the sort of social relationship that develops, particularly between the loan officer and the group itself. The loan officers tend to become friendly, a bit like George Bailey in the It's a Wonderful Life, with the people in the groups. And it tends to lead to a very high success payback rate, but it also tends to drive up the cost of the loans because they're very labor intensive. We were invited into the homes of some of the people who are receiving these loans. Here's a picture of a group meeting, and there's a loan officer there to the right, the woman on the farthest right of the picture. You can see the stack of papers that she has in front of her. She usually fills out the loan information by hand when the people repay it. And here the group is about, I think, to say a small prayer. They usually have a very solemn ceremony where they promise to pay back the loan, and they thank they thank God and the microfinance institution in particular for making these opportunities available to them. Collecting and entering the data into the databases can be a very time-consuming process, and the students are in part trying to reduce the costs of doing that because that leads to very high interest rates on the order of 30% to 40% for some of these loans. This photo is of several of our students, Scott and Kelsey there, and then working with Cesar Alfaro, the technology guru for the microfinance institution, and Alex, who was one of our students who was fluent in Spanish, partly doing translation. And they're working, trying to understand the structure of the database that their technology needs to interface with in order to expedite the loan process. Here's the final prototype pocket PC device that the students worked on. It takes data from the field. The loan officers can input the data on the device rather than on all the reams of paper that they had, and then upload and download to the computers, and it's a very time-consuming process that is eliminated by the device. One of the more noticeable things when we arrived in Pueblo Nuevo, the small rural village that we were living in Honduras, was a constant haze that was sort of in the air all the time, largely from slash-and-burn agriculture. It's reminiscent of the problem that microfinance institutions are struggling with as an industry, which is whether they should be responsible not only for the financial well-being of the people that they're serving, but also the environmental and the health effects, sometimes called the triple bottom line. Is there an incentive to protect the environment at the same time as doing good for the financial well-being of the folks? Here you'll see a recipient of one of the microfinance loans. Terrific story with this woman. She was receiving a loan in order to buy bread pans. You'll see the bread pans she's got stacked in the blue bin there beside her. And behind that is her bread oven. It's an old-fashioned wood-burning oven where she made bread, flatbreads for the town, and she was trying to get a loan to get more bread pans so she could expand her business. She was getting about $70 or $100 loan. One of the microfinance recipients that we visited was running a small business out of her home that was grinding tortillas and beans and corn for the local schools that she would sell. She was getting about $70 in order to replace the worn-out blade in this machine in order to support herself and her family, and this is her daughter here, and as well as provide a business and a service to the local school district. This rather jolly-looking woman is Senora Nixon. She was probably the poster child, if you will, of this microfinance institution called Covella in Honduras. This woman had received more than 30 loans. These loans are typically very short, 3 to 6 months, sometimes up to a year. And she'd received more than 30 of them. She'd used her first loan to buy a deep fryer for a food making business, sort of a roadside stand, and had expanded this business into a full-blown restaurant with a huge stove here. She was about to build a second floor on this restaurant. She'd really moved herself from poverty to the middle class. This is the entire microfinance team that I was working with in Honduras. The students are from a variety of disciplines, economics, computer science, and even languages. It's quite a multidisciplinary team because the problems of microfinance themselves are quite multidisciplinary. We were leveraging the infrastructure that Lehigh has on the ground there for its Lehigh and Hunch includes some digging in Mayan ruins for archaeology and the Students for Sustainable Development Project, which is doing a water quality infrastructure for a small rural town called Pueblo Nuevo. Well, thanks for watching. This is with Lehigh's College of Business and Economics.